Tell you what.
Shalom, shalom. Welcome to our casting here. Make sure you go to www.truedisciplesofchrist.org to make sure you get your fresh dose of Right Knowledge books and DVDs by Tazadaq Shah on remedy, on how to take control of your straw man, and of course, a lot of spiritual overstanding of the natural laws from Yahweh, and of course, the man-made laws here on the earth. We have a lot to share today. He has a lot to share today, so I'm going to go ahead and let him start.
All right, so this is actually, it's going to be pretty quick, but it's going to be very informative. Most of you need this, really. So first of all, giving all praises to the God of our forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. His proper name is Yahweh. So this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. She doesn't offer legal advice. Everything that's actually presented is strictly for educational, informational, entertainment purposes only, not to be taken or misconstrued as legal advice. In fact, I encourage you to research everything that I ever say. I challenge anyone to go on, you know, I want you to question it. You know what I mean? Anyone that doesn't want you to question them, you got to look out for it. So if you use the information, you fall flat on your face, it's your own fault. But in particularly, I'm doing this video for the good brother Evans and Fred Dickerson, the good brother Bernard, you know, so they won't get railroaded by these judges. I had a similar issue. There was a New York cab company that ran into my conveyance on Fifth Avenue. So we exchanged information, and the cab company, the driver, he told me, oh yeah, my company will cover it. But it turns out in the mail, I get a subpoena to show up to court. And then when I start to, like, you know, file suits against them, the black robe decides he's not going to accept my affidavits. And this is how I dealt with that particular situation. So we're going to go to the big screen. If you could actually go over there and control the computer, I'm going to focus in. And you're just going to keep your focus here on the screen now. You're in the audience. And by the way, share this video because there's a lot of people out there that's getting railroaded. I could require donations for this. And it would be beautiful if you decided to donate. And by the way, good brother Joel, thanks for the donation, brother. Kinshard, Yasha Allah, really, really appreciate your donation. And everyone else is really showing that kind of love to donations. But there's various different ways that you could actually donate. And again, join our assembly. Log on to www.truedisciplesofchrist.org and, you know, become one of the true disciples of Christ. So I'm going to go over something I actually submitted to the court. Of course, I took the people's names out here. I left my Nyman in there. But this is what it is. And I'm going to focus it on the screen so you're not going to see much of me. You're just going to hear my voice because I want you to get a clear depiction of this right here. So let me focus in on the screen. You don't have to move the screen just yet, your pa. Let me get a better focus here. Hopefully the light doesn't blind you. That looks fairly clear. Just really want the screen here. It's a 78-inch screen TV. So you should be able to get a clear picture here. Hopefully it's coming out clear on your end. Let's see. Let me take a little off of that. It's too much. That should work. So keep your focus on the screen, people. So now, let me just go over what's on the screen here. Would this be better with the light off? Let me see. It might be a bit clearer with the light off. I'll leave the light off for now. So, this is what happened. It was actually submitted in Kings County, New York City, in the court of Kings County, 9th Judicial District, Commonwealth or Republic of. This is a civil action. And of course, as you see over here, whatever, whoever the fictitious corporation, I don't want to say the name of the cab company, I left that out. But this is how you would actually do this. And particularly, if a black robe decides he's going to deny your affidavits, deny your paperwork, which is actually denying you due process of law, for educational purposes, I can't tell you to do this. I'm telling you this is what I did, and it was very effective. So, of course, your fictitious foreign corporation to which I did not agree to contract with, the state of New York. You know, you got some people over there in the state of New York saying, hey, man, we have control of your body. We own your body. And we want to inject you with anything. We'll do it. Well, okay. Let's see what the law said. Case number, I just put zero there because I don't want you to go and look at the case. And essentially, this is a notice and demand, a written of error, a common norbis. So, demand for dismissal. So I'm demanding that this case be dismissed. Scroll up a little bit, huh? Use the arrow over here, just scroll up. Yeah, if you use that, yeah. A little bit more. A little bit more, please. Right there, you can stop right there. So, you're going down, you see right here, defendant in error. Non-corporate entity. I'm a non-corporate entity, of course. I'm a secure party creditor. You guys need to become a secure party creditor. Again, what are you waiting for? So, again, fictitious entity, foreign corporation, state of New York, a fictitious state. Because it's a fictitious state because they are actually franchisees of the federal United States. Speak up for a second. Huh?
All right. So, make sure to share and subscribe, of course, and get the books and DVDs so you can get that right knowledge. You'll be glad you did.
All right, excuse me for that, pardon me for that. So, I screw up a little bit. So, fictitious entity, of course. So, this is actually my rebuttal of a verified complaint. Scroll up. Okay, so now, if you're dealing with this, you're going to put the name of the black robe over here, Judge So-and-so, for educational purposes only. And the so-called Esquire that might have actually been in the case, as you see over here. So, this is a rebuttal, a verified complaint, and proof of claims. So I'm saying prove your claim, and so on and so forth. So this is a disqualification of the black robe so-and-so. Let's say black robe John Doe, or black robe jackass, so-and-so. Scroll up just a little bit. Okay, a little bit more. All right, stop right there. So to all concerned, case number, whatever your case is. Now comes Tazadaq Sharbay. I'm the complainant. I'm not a defendant. I'm the complainant. I'm the man, should I say, that's filing the claim that they call a complaint. So I'm the complainant, and pursuant to Article 6, Clause 2 of the Organic Constitution of the United States of America, which was the Republic, as per the Supremacy Clause. The Supremacy Clause. If you're not familiar with it, you need to get familiar with it, especially if you're calling yourself a Moor. This is the pertinent part that you want to be concerned about if you're calling yourself a Moor or Israelite. Article 6, Section 2. The affiant, that being me, because I'm the one that filed the affidavits, has not been seen or presented with any documentation verifying that I have voluntarily, knowingly, and intentionally entered into a contract with any civil court. So I never contracted with them. You understand what I'm saying? To perform to your demands. So since I didn't contract with them, I'm not obligated to perform to their demands and believe that no such verified, not verifiable, meaning in the future, but verified, meaning it hasn't been verified, exists. So, affidavit has not seen or been presented with any documentations. Let me stay over here out of the way, and I'll speak over here. Affidavit has not been seen or has been presented with any documentations verifying that all the terms of the contract were disclosed in the document and believes that no such verified documents exist. In other words, now, hold on, son, huh? Don't move the screen. I'll let you know when to move. So, and otherwise, when they have not verified anything, then, hey, man, If a verified claim doesn't exist, then there's no reason for me to be there. So as a matter of law, I'm going to have the so-called whole case dismissed because there's no verified complaint or claim against me under oath or affirmation. You understand? So now we're going into the affidavit of validation. Scroll up a little bit. Stop right there, please. So, affidavit of validation. I hereby also demand to receive the following proof of claims answered. So I'm demanding that this is actually answered. This is an affidavit, also a notice and demand. Please respond an affidavit of validation or verification of claim. The claim has to be verified. Everything that they're alleging has to be verified. And in order for that to have to be verified, someone has to swear under oath or affirmation. You understand what I'm saying? You're letting these people get away with actually just making an allegation. No one is actually taking their hand and swearing in as a man or a woman. So if there's no verified claim or complaint against me, I'm going to believe it. In this case, it's going to be dismissed. For under your full and competent commercial, corporate, and personal liability that you have proofs of claim. If there's no proof of claim against me, they have no validity. Number one, proof of claim that you had the authority under the Constitution. You need to listen to this very well, good brother Bernard, because they try and railroad you yesterday. Proof of claims that you had the authority under the Constitution as per your oath of office. As you see, I'm holding them to their oath. All public officials take an oath of the Federal Republic Constitution and of the state Constitution to completely deny and dismiss all of my affidavits, because this is what they're doing to many of you. They're dismissing your paperwork, your affidavits, and so on and so forth, and you don't know what to do. You say, oh, Tazadaq, they denied it. Well, what did you do? You took door number one, which either you went silent, acquiescence, or you got in and you argue. Both of those are dishonors. So, to completely deny, dismiss all of my affidavits, evidence, documents, papers, jurisdiction on constitutional demands and challenges, and all other forms or claims as per your judicial determination signed by you on May the 1st, 2019, because that's when it happened to you, good brother Fled Dickerson. Number two, proof of claim that by complete stripping, eliminating, and suppressing all my claims, proofs, documents, and demands, and leaving me naked before the court without any evidence in support of my case is not a violation of my constitutional rights and liberties. Scroll up to number three now, huh? A little bit higher. Stop right there, that's good. So proof of claim, number three, proof of claim that the law allowed judges to be handed a document by any esquire without you even reading it and signing it, denying and dismissing all my motions, all affidavits, all papers, all documents, all judicial and constitutional demands, and all other grounds as per the document you signed. Number four, proof of claim. And this is all conditional acceptance upon proof of claim, yet a notice of demand. Proof of claim that the plaintiff do not have to prove their claim as the moving parties is in their verified complaint. Number five, proof of claim that the defendant has to prove the claim of the plaintiffs as per your judicial determinations and demand. Number six, proof of claim that I, as a defendant in error, has to answer by law a verified complaint against another verified complaint from the plaintiff who is the moving party that refuses to answer my affidavits of rebuttal of their verified complaint. Number seven, proof of claim that the defendant has received a certified copy with proof of return receipt of the new amended verified complaint to respond to in the time frame demanded. Number eight, proof of claim that this civil court has a verifiable contract signed by me before trial. Have any of you ever questioned that? No. You think you know the law, which is why I tell you to get my books and read them thoroughly and read them over and over again, giving the court the complete jurisdiction over a non-corporate living man. Okay, scroll up, hon, please. Stop on number eight. A little bit more. All right, good, right there. Excuse me. Scroll up to number eight. All right, stop right there. Right there. Number nine, proof of claim that any barristers and or solicitors are persons from any foreign country without having to be here in the USA can file a long-distance verified complaint from inside Canada and does not have to be here to testify at court at any trial. Number 10, proof of claim that as judge that you have subject matter jurisdiction or authority in an Article 1 court. Number 11, proof of claim that as judge you have subject matter jurisdiction or authority in an Article 3 court. Number 12, proof of claim that as a judge you have subject matter jurisdiction or authority in an Article 4 court. Number 13, proof of claim that as stated by you, that you are a judge presiding in an Article 5 court. Number 14, proof of claim that as a judge that you will do not have to protect my constitutional liberties rights as per your oath of office, both state and federal. Scroll up, huh? Please. Stop right there. Number 15, proof of claim that the name judicial court is not a private corporation, which it is. Even thought Dunn and Pryor Street, Dunn's number, was supplied and entered into the court record and sent to the plaintiffs that the court listed themselves as a private corporation. I hope you guys are paying attention, man. Proof of claim that the state of Florida is not a private corporation, that the state of New York is not a private corporation, that the state of Maryland is not a private corporation, and so on and so forth, and that the causes of actions are not rem against the defendant. Proof of claim that you and the court, corporation, department, etc., has given me full and complete disclosure over any and all contracts or over anything and everything claim. Number 17, proof of claim that you have complete authority over a secure party creditor, sovereign, non-corporate living man within the country. Number 18, proof of claim that you have complete authority over this living man upon the land, Tazadaq Shah Bay, the undaunted national secure party creditor. Number 19, proof of claim that you have a registered member of the Bar Association. Scroll up, please. A little bit more. Stop right there. It's good. Number 20, proof of claim that the American Bar Association is not a foreign international private organization, which makes bar members foreign agents in a foreign state under the Foreign Sovereignty Immunity Act. Do you understand? Proof of claim that the bar members actually have a license to practice law. Prove it. They don't have a license to practice law. They have a bar card. Proof of claim of any lawful law that proves that a non-corporate man upon the law has to pay court a tax or a fine. Proof of claim that the Supreme Court in each state were actually following a state and federal real law that permitted the fellow bar members of the Supreme Court to allow fellow bar members in each state and federal government as part of the judicial branch of government in each state and the federal government courts. 21. Proof of claim that you as judge are above the Supreme Court's rulings and that you are above the law of this land. Number 22. Proof of claim that the Constitution is not the supreme law of the land and or in this or any court, and that you do not have to adhere to your oath of office to uphold the said oath of the Constitution of both the Republic and the state. Scroll up, please. Number 22. Proof of claim that the Constitution is not the supreme law of the land and or in this or any court, that you do not have to adhere to your oath of office to uphold the said oath and the Constitution. 23. Proof of claim that you can prove the law you asked for that would supply the proof of why you should not have dismissed all my affidavits and documents. This is what you got to throw at them, family. 24. Proof of claim of why my affidavits of denial of corporate existence was not allowed under FISA. F-I-S-A. 25. Proof of claim of your authority under the organic and corporate constitution to completely deny a writ of cum robert nobis. 26. Proof of claim that the court upon challenge will does not have to rebut or disprove the fact
that I am not a corporation. I'm the living soul. 27. Proof of claim. The affidavits and statements of facts are not proof of anything and will not be allowed to be presented as trials as your prejudgment. 28. Proof of claim that the sworn affidavits and statements of facts cannot be dismissed as evidence when the evidence within the affidavits will clearly prove the claims of the defendant. Scroll up, please. 29. Proof of claim that the verified complaints are admissible as evidence and sworn affidavits or not. Proof of claim that an unrebutted affidavit by plaintiffs has standing and will be completely ignored in your or any court. 31. Proof of claim that an Article 5 court is a civil court of record which was passed by Congress. 32. Proof of claim that the contract fraud does not violate a contract and does not make it null and void. 33. Proof of claim that under the common law and the UCC 1-308 and UCC 1-103.6, I did not have the right to reserve my rights and to demand my fiat, so-called money, back and file a lien to secure my monies defrauded from me. 34. Proof of claim that you have not allowed Esquire, I should have take that name out of there, erase that name, I don't want that name there. Backspace and erase that name. Alright, thanks. Just click on save. To amend without full disclosure to me his new verified complaint in order for you both to refuse and deny my constitutional rights and liberties to a jury trial. 35. Proof of claim. Take that name out. That John Doe, I don't want really their names out there, did not file asking for a higher punitive damages and fines in the original verified complaint giving me the right to a trial by jury. Scroll up, please. Stopped on 35. Stop right there. That's good. Proof of claim that based upon your actions against my constitutional rights and liberties, that you are not in violation of your oath of office. 37. Proof of claim that based upon your actions, you were not an advocate of the plaintiff's Esquire by stating that the verified complaints are admissible as evidence and that my sworn affidavits are not and won't be allowed in your court. You know, you see what I'm saying, Brother Flood Dickinson? Is this not what they done to you, Bernard? Come on. 38. Proof of claim that based upon your actions that any observer could see that a fair and impartial trial was not possible in the Ninth Circuit Court. 39. Proof of claim that the affidavit of notice of fraud upon the court was nonsense, as you stated. And by the way, good brother Flood Dickinson, they trying to tell you you couldn't use words like contract. So how you getting due process of law? They telling you can't use phrases like contract and things like that. They trying to railroad you. Number 40. Proof of claim of why you should not be disqualified because of your numerous violations of my rights and liberties. 41. Proof of claim of any law passed by Congress that can deny me the right to hire my own court stenographer, that means your court reporter, so that you can understand, in a jury trial or any and other and all trials. See, the reason they don't want you to have that in there, your own court reporter, because then what's recorded is going on the record. And then when you file an appeal, chances are you're going to win because everything's on the record. Scroll up, please. So, this is pretty much the end of it. Affidavit present to 29 United States Code, Title 1746. See Dickinson versus Wainwright, 62F2D, Title 1184. Held affidavit, sworn true and correct under penalty of perjury, has full force of the law and does not have to be verified by notary republic to have the same effect. Understand that. Under penalty of perjury, I declare that the foregoing facts within the document, verified complaint, affidavit, are true and correct and complete. Without prejudice, all rights reserved. UCC 1-20308, Tazadaq Short. So with that,
I'm gonna bring this to an end. I know that was quick, but it was a lot of information, and it will get you a lot of positive results. So I'm just gonna tell you, you're gonna have to gird up your loins like a man and stand up and face the tyranny. Or you could just tap out, and you can continue to get railroaded. It's not gonna get better. It's gonna get worse. Blasio told you best. We own your body, and we will inject you with anything that we want. Don't matter what it is. And hey, pretty much, you're going to like it. And for the weak, you're just going to tap out to the tyranny. But I happen to be one of the rebellious slaves. You understand? That, you know, seek freedom. I guess you could consider me the 2019 Nat Turner. So I'm going to hit him with a Nat Turner lick, which is right knowledge through the spirit of Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shah. So with that, I'm going to say Shalom, like the video, share the video. Very resourceful. It should get you some victories. Tazadaq is out. Shalom. Thank you.